फिजिक्स क्लास 11 चैप्टर 6 वर्क एनर्जी एंड पावर। वेरियस फॉर्म्स ऑफ एनर्जी। नंबर 1 हीट एनर्जी। फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स इज नॉट अ कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स। नाउ वी नो दैट द फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स इज नॉट अ कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स। हाउएवर वर्क इज एसोसिएटेड विद द फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन। बट वी नो दैट द वर्क इज एसोसिएटेड विद अ फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन। काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ एनी ऑब्जेक्ट मूविंग विद स्पीड वी reduces due to frictional force. Now, when an object is moving with a speed v, then slowly its kinetic energy will decrease because of the friction force. In example 6.5, a block of mass m sliding on a rough surface with speed v naught comes to a halt over a distance x naught. Work done by the force of kinetic friction F over x naught is minus F of x naught. Now, in example 6.5, we have studied that a block of mass M, suppose it is sliding over a surface which is a rough and it is moving with a speed V naught. Then it will come to halt after, suppose, traveling the distance x naught. Then the work done by the force of kinetic friction will be given as minus of F of x naught. Now, by work energy theorem, m v naught square by 2 equal to f of x naught. So, this relation is from the work energy theorem. This is the kinetic energy and this is the work done. On examination of the block and the table or the surface, rough surface, we would detect a slight increase in their temperatures. Now, suppose if you examine the contact surface of the block and the horizontal surface. Okay, if you the surface which is in contact, if you detect, if you check out, then you will see that there will be little heat. It will be, the temperature will be increased. That means the work done by friction is transferred as heat energy. That means the work done by the friction is transferred into heat energy, and that we call it as the heat energy. Similarly, in the winter, if you rub your hand, then you see that your hand gets warmed up. That means there also heat energy is produced. 1 kg of water releases about 42,000 joule of energy when it cools by 10 degrees Celsius. If you have got 1 kg of water and it releases, if you are cooling down this by 10 degrees Celsius, then the energy which is released is 42,000 joule. 1 calorie equal to 4.2 joule. And 1 kilocalorie equal to 4.2 into 10 power 3 joule. So this is conversion of calorie into joule. Okay, this is kilocalorie into joule. Number 2 is chemical energy. Chemical energy arises from the fact that the molecules participating in the chemical reaction have different binding energies. So the chemical energy is connected or associated with the chemical reaction. Okay, so it arises why? Because of the fact that the molecule participating in the chemical reaction have different binding energies. So because of that, the energy is released or absorbed, that we call it as a chemical energy. A stable chemical compound has less energy than the separate parts. So if you have got a compound, chemical compound, then it has got less energy than the constituent parts which are separate, okay, free. When it is bound together, then it becomes stable and it has got less energy. Okay, so that is a stable chemical compound has less energy than the separate parts, that is separate constituents which are taking part in the chemical reaction. Exothermic reaction. If the total energy of the reactants is more than the products of the reaction, heat is released. This reaction is said to be an exothermic reaction. So if there is a release in the heat, then that reaction, chemical reaction, we call it as an exothermic reaction. Endothermic. If the total energy of the reactants is less than the products of the reaction, heat is absorbed, then the reaction is endothermic. And if the reverse process, then the exothermic. In that, suppose the energy is absorbed in the chemical reaction, then you call that reaction as an endothermic reaction. Chemical energy is associated with the forces that give rise to the stability of substance. So the chemical energy will give the stability to the substance. Number 3, electrical energy. E is equal to V into Q. V is a potential energy and Q is the charge. This energy is associated with an electric current. So electric energy is associated with the current, electric current. There are laws governing the attraction and repulsion of charges and currents. Now there are laws which govern the attraction and repulsion of the charges and the currents. We will study it later on. The flow of electric current causes bulbs to glow, fans to rotate and bells to ring, etc. So we know the uses of electric current. It will allow the bulb to glow, fans to rotate, bells to ring, and many other ways the currents are useful. Number 4, the equivalence of mass and energy. Albert Einstein showed that mass and energy are equivalent and are related by E equal to mc square. The Einstein said that mass and energy are equivalent, and the relation between them he gave by the equation E equal to mc square. E is the energy, m is the mass, and c is the speed of light in vacuum. Its value is 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. For 1 kg of matter, suppose you have got the mass of 1 kg, then how much energy is released or how much equivalent energy is there? So for that, let us place the value m is equal to 1 into c is 3 into 10 power 8 whole square. So 3 square is 9, 10 power 8 power 2 will give you 10 power 16, 8 into 2, 16. So this much, this is joule, 9 into 10 power 16 joule. So 1 kg of matter or a substance will be equivalent to the energy 9 into 10 power 16 joule. This is equivalent to the annual electrical output of a large 3000 megawatt power generating station. So this is a very large amount of the power or the energy. Number 5, nuclear energy. In fission and fusion, nuclear energy is released. Now we have got two types of nuclear reactions. One is fission and fusion. In this, energy is released. In the sun, four light hydrogen nuclei fuse to form a helium nucleus whose mass is less than the sum of the mass of reactants. Now the fusion reaction naturally takes place in the sun. In sun, what happens is there are four light hydrogen nuclei which fuse together and they will form a nucleus of helium. Okay, when it is forming this helium nucleus, the mass of these helium nucleus is less than the sum of the mass of reactants. This mass difference called the mass defect delta m, and there is a mass difference. Okay, that mass difference we call it as a delta m, that is called mass defect. And this is the source of energy delta m c square, and this will be converted into energy by using the Einstein's equation E is equal to mc square. So it will be converted into the energy. So m will be the mass defect, that is delta m, and c square equal to E. So you will get the energy released. In fission, a heavy nucleus like uranium-235U is split by neutron into lighter nuclei. Now in fission, we have got heavy nuclei which is bombarded by a neutron, and it will be break into or split into lighter nuclei. The final mass is less than the initial mass, and in this process the final mass will be less than the initial mass, and therefore the mass difference that you call as mass defect will be translated into energy using the same formula, the formula of E equal to mc square. Okay, this same formula it will be used and transform into the energy. Now next we have got the this energy. See, this fusion and fission, they are useful if it is controlled, they are harmful if they are uncontrolled. Okay, so if it is controlled fission, then it will be useful or it will be used in many other ways. But if it is suppose uncontrolled, like nuclear bombs, then it will be harmful. Okay, so that is the we can say that fission is useful as well as it is not useful. And the energy which is released, we can tap to provide electrical energy as in nuclear power plant. And as I say that it will be controlled nuclear reaction, it can be done in nuclear power plant. That otherwise, if you say uncontrolled, then it will be in the nuclear bomb. Next, we have got the relation between electron volt and joule. Okay, EV, that is electron volt, and J is a joule. So 1 EV, that is 1 electron volt, equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 joule. So this is the relation of electron volt and joule. Principle of conservation of energy. Energy can be transformed from one form to another, but the total energy of an isolated system remains constant. So we know that the energy can be transformed from one form to other, but the total energy of the isolated system remains constant. energy can neither be created nor destroyed. So energy we cannot create, neither we can destroy, but it will remain constant. But you, and also you can convert it from one form to other form. Some users are given in your textbook. They are all electronic communication and mechanical devices rely on some form of some forms of energy transformation. So transforming energy from one way to other, one form to other, on that depends the many electrical devices, mechanical devices, communication devices. Example 6.10. Examine table 6.1 to 6.3 and express number A, the energy required to break one bond in DNA in EV. Number B, the kinetic energy of an air molecule 10⁻²⁰ joule in EV. And number C, the daily intake of human adult in calories. This is the table 6.1. This is a table 6.2, typical kinetic energies K. This is table 6.3, approximate energy associated with various phenomena. So in part A, energy required to break one bond of DNA equal to 10⁻²⁰ joule divided by 1.6 into 10⁻¹⁹ joule per electron volt. If you simplify this, you get the value as 0.06 electron volt, 0.06 EV, that is electron volt. Part B is the kinetic energy of an air molecule is 10⁻²⁰ joule divided by 1.6 into 10⁻¹⁹ joule per electron volt. This is, if you simplify, the answer approximately is 0.0062 electron volt EV. And part C is the average human consumption in a day equal to 10⁻⁷ joule divided by 4.2 into 10⁻³ joule per kilocalorie. To simplify, the value is 2400 kilocalorie. So that is the solution for example 6.10, part 1, A, B, and C. Okay, we'll keep this much for today. Thank you very much.